Welcome to the partner parishes of St. John Baptiste de la Salle and St. Mary Our Lady of Lourdes, and thank you for joining us in these unique circumstances. We invite your full participation in the Triduum liturgies with Bishop Malesic in the live streams, which can be found on the diocesan website, www.dioceseofgreensburg.org. From our parishes, we'll be making available some footage and images of our celebration here so that you can participate also in your parishes. We hope that they will help you in your prayer and to stay connected to your parish and help you to find some way of celebrating these sacred days in your home. You can find more resources for your participation or make an online gift to our parishes at our website, stjohnstmary.net. A special thanks to our skeleton crew who have made this possible to bring to you, including our ministers, decorator, and our videographer. Now let us pray together.
When our Lord Jesus gave us the gift of the Most Holy Eucharist, when he gave us the greatest commandment to love one another. He instituted the holy priesthood and assured us that he would be with us forever. As we gather this evening, as we celebrate this Eucharist, mindful that we're doing so with so many making a spiritual communion who are yet still truly present through this great communion of saints, we welcome back the great hymn of the Church. I invite you to join me now in singing the Gloria.
The lamb must be a year old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, you shall eat it like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt. I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow shall come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you. that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So, during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with the towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "She will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. So you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, You ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening. Tonight is usually a celebration full of many rich symbols. I always look forward to celebrating this liturgy, and I was very much looking forward to my first Paschal Triduum here at St. John's and St. Mary's as pastor, my first pastorate, just to immerse myself in the beauty of this liturgy and of the so many symbols that we're familiar with. The oils that usually are presented, freshly blessed and consecrated before Mass. The water of foot washing, the bread and wine of the Eucharist, all signs of the priesthood and of the sacraments. Tonight is usually a feast rich for my Catholic soul. I remember my first Holy Thursday as a priest. After washing the feet, I was at Mount St. Peter's in New Kensington. And I remember after that, the profound act of washing feet, I was so moved by what I had just done. I returned back to the chair where I was glad that Monsignor was presiding and not me, because I was a wet mess. I was unable to carry on. I couldn't recollect myself. Tonight I want to weep for a different reason, because I don't have the opportunity to be with you all, to celebrate this liturgy, to partake of the washing of feet, to do that ritual. These are very strange times. Many times this week, over the course of the week, I've said to myself, it does not feel like Holy Week. It is so strange. It's very strange to be talking to the folks in the camera instead of here in front of me. As Catholics, we are so accustomed to our rituals. And that's a good thing. They help us to enter into and to celebrate the sacred mysteries, the passion, death, and resurrection of our Lord and our God. Yet unfortunately this year, we are unable to be together as we usually are, to celebrate those rituals together. There is no doubt a great sadness that we all feel. And yet, although we cannot be together, it does not mean that the Lord is not at work in our lives. The gifts that God has given us remain. We are still united in faith. We are still part of a great communion of saints, celebrating this liturgy throughout the world, in church and in our homes and in our hearts. We still are called to follow the words of Jesus. Love one another. As we mourn our communal celebration of the Holy Week rituals this year, we know we've had a lot to mourn lately with so many things in our world changing, the opportunity to gather together with friends or family, to have gatherings and sports and activities, and school events. I'm confident that the Lord, through the Holy Spirit, is prompting us to participate in ways that are different. And yet, if we are open to it, no less powerful. Indeed, there's a plethora of opportunities out there through virtual means that we might participate in our liturgies, that we might pray together and gather together, that we still can participate in acts of loving service. It might even be an invitation to a deeper, if different, participation from our homes.
What do I mean? Tonight, as we celebrate the institution of the priesthood and of the Eucharist, priests all over the world are celebrating their gift of service in empty churches. But friends, consider this. The feeling of emptiness that I experience and that you experience unites us with Jesus' self-emptying to save us. In tonight's gospel, we witness the depths of the emptying of Christ, and over these next few days, I'm very often and deeply moved at the words that the choir usually sings tonight beautifully. An image of Jesus' self-emptying. I, your Lord and Master, now become your servant. I, who made the moon and stars, will kneel to wash your feet. This is my commandment, to love as I have loved you. Kneel to wash each other's feet, as I have done for you. Our Lord Jesus assumed the form of a slave, as St. Paul tells us, and that marvelous ancient hymn to the Philippians, God himself has become vulnerable. God himself has rendered himself vulnerable. He has washed feet, taken the place of a slave. That feeling of being humbled that we experience right now, of relinquishing the control of everything that we have in our lives, unites us to that gesture of Jesus. The feelings of fear and of uncertainty unite us to the prayer of our Lord in the garden. Father, take this cup away. The experience of suffering and of pain, physically, emotionally, spiritually, and psychologically, unite us to his journey to Calvary, carrying the cross, his passion and death for us. The feeling of abandonment unites us to Christ's cry on the cross. That feeling of isolation unites us to the experience of the tomb on Holy Saturday. And the intense realization that we are, in fact, joined with Christians throughout the world helps us to experience the resurrection on Easter Sunday. So friends, these days of quarantine and isolation, the absence of our physical presence together at these saving mysteries, in it we can find profound spiritual union with Christ and with each other, because we are his body. That's the goal of these rituals, isn't it? To lead us each deeper into the mystery of Christ. To, as he emptied himself, empty ourselves of human and worldly attachments, to be more surrendered to his love. Today in the first reading, we hear the story of Passover, when God told his people Israel to gather together in their homes to share a special and sacred meal, marking their doors so that the angel of the Lord would pass over them and rescue them from a plague. That has never sounded so familiar to our experience of Holy Week, I think. The Jews keep this meal every year, and Christians, the holy sacrifice of the Mass, which is the completion and fulfillment of the Passover of the Lord every single day. What we both believe about this night is not just a remember, Christians and Jews, it's not just a remembrance of past events like telling a story or watching a home movie like maybe we've done in these last weeks, but a true participation in them. We are there. We participate deeply in those saving events, and the grace from them is applied to our lives thousands of years later. Do this in memory of me. We are profoundly united with our Christians around the world in his great mystical body, and that's what makes this time different from any other? That famous question of the Passover meal. My hope and prayer is that the emptying of ourselves allows a fuller participation in these rituals, in this holy night, that it can become more real for us, more spiritual, more transformative in our lives. May the mandatum, the great commandment of love that Christ gave to each of us, take flesh in our hearts and in our actions and in our homes. And I know that that's happening for some. So many people have told me, Father, I miss the Eucharist. I miss daily Mass. I miss coming to communion. I'll never take it for granted again. As we continue our physical fasts, for most of our people, from our rituals, from the sacraments, from the Eucharist, may we allow that emptying to inspire in us a deeper longing, a deeper love, a deeper union with Jesus in spiritual communion with his self-emptying sacrifice. God bless you. Friends, united in faith, we offer our needs, prayers, and petitions. We place them, united as God's mystical body, we place them before the Lord.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For all leaders and members of the Church, that the mandatum of Christ may inspire her to rededicate herself to the life of service and sacrificial self-giving. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That on this night in which the Lord established the priesthood, all priests will recommit themselves to holiness with renewed zeal. For Father Dan, for our priests who have served in our parishes, for our two parish seminarians, and for an increase in vocations to the priesthood, we pray to the Lord. That the power of the Holy Eucharist will penetrate the hearts of all people, especially those making spiritual communion tonight, so that Christ will become the source and summit of their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the coronavirus pandemic, for the protection of healthcare workers and those on the front lines, wisdom for leaders, unity in families, peace for the anxious, solace for those afraid and alone, and a shared spirit of sacrifice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who will be reborn in the waters of baptism this year, or celebrate sacraments of initiation and First Holy Communion, may Christ's renewing power change their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the event of Christ's passion will generate lasting peace in the world and inspire consolation in all who suffer in their conformity to Christ crucified. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and homeland of our faith community, and for those unable to physically join us around the altar of praise, may they experience peace, comfort, healing, and unity in the spiritual communion of the Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may rest in peace in heaven with the angels and saints, especially for all priests, living and deceased, whom we remember at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious Father, may these petitions, those of the quiet of each of our hearts, that we present to you now through Christ,
our Lord.
That my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of the sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest, who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice, and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith, remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day on which our Lord Jesus Christ was handed over for our sake, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas, and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our peace in your days, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our peace in your days and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, and for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation, be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice and spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant to them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us, your servants, also who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints, and bid us, we beseech you, and through their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command inform our divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace while maintaining proper social spacing.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
As we conclude our liturgy this evening, ordinarily we would have a beautiful procession to a place of repose, reminiscent of the garden where we would be invited to pray and watch with the Lord Jesus. I invite for those who are participating by means of modern communication to spend some time in prayer. Make your own words of Jesus. Father, not my will, but yours be done. We heed his invitation to stay and watch and pray with him as we undergo the